Look at this ugly beast. Welcome to episode 9 of my Let's Play GT Legends. Previous episode, you saw me failing in, or sort of failing in, the AC Cobra. I managed to bring home a podium in that challenge, but I was barely able to drive the car. I could drive the Cobra in the coming challenge, which is the final challenge of this stage. It's a rather long one, 8 lap races, I think on 6 tracks. But for now I will pick this ugly car here. It's a TBR Griffith 400, 1020 kilograms, 261 kilowatts, and I've test driven it a bit. It's much tamer, but I think fun to drive. We'll see. I can barely afford it, but let's go for it. Nope, don't test. Let's go here. 60s GT7 full classic GT championship. Pretty much every car from this stage. Unfortunately, I can't pick or even buy the Shelby Daytona or the Ferrari 275. That would have been nice. I'm sure there's a way to win these cars, but I didn't. Yeah, I was right. 6 tracks. Mondello, Spa, Monza. Monza in the full configuration. Manicure, Dijon, and Hockenheim. Hockenheim being the only track in the short configuration. And Mondello not in the full configuration, but in the second longest. Let's go. I have a lot of cars by now. I bought the Shelby GT. I tested it, but I prefer the TBR, to be honest. Let's go. This time I won't do any practice. I'll just adjust the setup a bit. What is it? 8 laps. Gearing. You can't change any of the various gears, for example. You only can change the final gearing, or you can't change the tires and all of other options in those 60s GT cars classes. I think you can with when you go higher. I could even change differential. I don't care. Only thing I want to do is actually I'll go shorter here, and I was a bit too understeering for me, so let's put this one, yeah, like this and like this. Save. And set as favorite mode, whatever. And go straight to the race. Could even drive the alarm again. Huh. Sounds nice. Tested the E-Type, it's too slow. I think the Mercedes is just has the same problem. Guys, hello. Good beginning. There's definitely a problem with the AI on this track in the start. Big field. Not sure about that anti-roll bar change. It's fun. Oh, this, I hate to say it, but this car. I prefer this car a lot to the Cobra. Can do silly things too. A lot of power, no question. I'm so scared of this corner. Corvette guy behind me is not too happy about me being there. Okay, where am I? I think in B4. B7? Are you kidding? Okay. Braver. Oh god. That was too brave. Okay, now I know how to drive this track, and this is my final restart. Sorry, mates. Oh, he's really enjoying this. He's having a good time. Maybe I should qualify with such a big field. previous starts were definitely better. Okay, where am I? P7 again. How have I ever managed to do a playthrough of this? With which car? Why am I having frame rate issues? Are you kidding? No. What is happening here? Something bad is happening. I can feel a crash coming. Computer crash. Delicate on the brakes. It's downhill. Same here. I don't believe it. AI problems here, and usual me driving problems. Yes, sure. always mess up here. Okay, now I will try not to slide as much. Maybe there is tire heat up. There is my backlight. All the driving assist aids are still turned off. This is way too hot. I am getting sort of frustrated. Okay. See you in a bit. Easy. Easy with the car. That's the main problem. I just run you over. What is that? Instant spin. The fact that I need to finish challenging the top three. I don't get it. Why is it undrivable now? Okay, change of tactics. If this works, I don't know. I pick the Cobra again. If I have to drive in an undrivable car, at least I want to have one that's really fast. Oh, seating position is not correct. I'll fix this afterwards. The next race. I don't know what to do. I have started this race for about, I don't know, 20 times. The AI is extremely quick. I am slow. I have troubles driving the car. Initially I was happy with the car, but now I just can't keep it straight. I even switched back to the Cobra, thinking that if I have a car that is undrivable, at least I want to have one that is really quick. Didn't work either. It's a very competitive field. 24 cars, including me, and I honestly don't know if I can do this, or how I can do this. I've tried to edit AI driver strength in the .plr file, put it now down from 100 to 80, but I've put it down to 90 previously, and when I reopened that file after I exited the game, I saw that the changes were reverted to 100. And the same with the seat adjustment. It's weird somehow. I'm not sure how that works and when the file gets overwritten and how. I guess I don't have any other tactics as than to try again and try to stay cool and not spin the car and don't get punched out of the way by stupid AI drivers. Wish me luck, guys. It's, I didn't think this would be this challenging. Look at him on the outside. They have super grip. Problem is, when I push, I crash. When I don't push, I get crashed. Survived lap 1, P9. I don't know how to keep this car straight. No idea. First part of the track, where I seem to be really slow. I force him off track. Interesting. Thank you. Look at him. Don't think that AI strength adjustment worked. Laps. Is that a Lotus Elan ahead of me? No. Something different. I think back when I played this game for the first time, I did this challenge with the Elan. Which is kind of stupid because it's extremely underpowered. No braking for some reason. I don't get it.
Thank you.
no idea how I can do this. Believe me, I haven't struggled with a car in iRacing ever. Like this, I mean, of course I've struggled with cars, but not like this. Can only hope that especially this track here, the driving is so bad. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. It really is the Lotus Elan. This is my last desperate attempt at doing this. I still don't know how to adjust the AI. Really adjust them, apart from setting the difficulty level to one notch down, which activates some driver assists, and I haven't really done the research how to turn it off again. So, I will try this, maybe it works. At least I should know how to drive this car. If I have issues with this car too, then it's definitely me and not anything with the sim. Okay, pick the escape route. Don't know why I'm starting on the other side now. Already crashes. Pick the second here. Thank you. I don't really feel quicker, but at least safer. At least I can do this again. Yeah, I think it was my driving. Push with this car for a change. With the TVR, I always felt right on the edge to crashing. Same with the Cobra. A lot of time in this lap. Wow. Really, there's a big change how quick the AI all of a sudden are compared to the previous challenges. That's a bit, I don't know, ridiculous. Maybe it's only this track and I'm doing all of this for no reason. But to be honest, I don't think so. Need to pass at least these two guys. The rest of the field is just out of reach. Not if I drive like this. Come on. To adjust force feedback again for this small wheel rim. That's way too hard. It's like a workout. Closer again. Okay, maybe into turn one. Or here. Yes. P6. Side action. I can hear the Corvette. I feel ashamed that I had to fall back to this sort of easy car, although I remember when I thought this car was really, really a bitch. Maybe I can still top 5. Not like this. That Daytona guy has found some speed and I found the gear somehow. That was all I could manage. Oh. Wow, wow, wow. Best lap time 130.6 basically, and I think in the TBR my best lap, at least when I checked, was a 32. Still 1.5 seconds off pace. Yeah, I think I'll end this episode here. Depends on how much I actually cut out of all that stuff I did before this race, so maybe the next race is still in it. If not, thanks for watching. See you soon.